In this video, I am going to explain how to enter bank related transactions in a journal. In a previous video, already we have understood how to enter receipt related and payment related transactions in a journal, and already we have understood how to enter these receipt related and payment related transactions in a payment voucher and receipt voucher. In this video, we are going to learn how to enter bank related transactions in a journal, and the same example I will take and I will explain how to enter these transactions in a vouchers, contra voucher. Okay, next one, three example I have taken here. Bank related transactions means what things we can do. We can withdraw amount from the bank, we can deposit amount cash into a bank, and we can transfer amount from one bank to another bank. These all things we can do in a contra entry. So all these three examples I have taken in this video. So I will explain how to enter these bank related transactions in a journal. Here you can see this table. This table is a golden rule table. By following this table, we are going to enter the accounts in a credit and debit. In every transaction, there will be two accounts because we are following double entry system of accounting. So in every transactions, we try to find out two accounts on which account this transaction is going to affect. Okay, this is the transaction. Now I will read this transaction. Okay, next one, rupee 5000 deposited in a SBI bank. We have 5000 rupee, so this amount we are going to deposit in a SBI bank. So okay, what we are going to pay here? Rupee 5000 rupee we are going to pay here. So if it is a rupee 5000 rupee, then this is called as a cash account. Next one is, in which bank we are going to pay? We are going to pay in a SBI bank. So this is what? SBI bank. These are the two accounts this transaction is going to affect. Okay, cash account is what? Always cash, building, assets and goods, these all things will come under real account. So this cash account will come under real account. Next one is SBI bank. SBI bank, organizations, bank names, person name, account, these all things will come under personal account. So SBI bank will come under personal account. Next one is, here I am going to write the accounts, real account and personal account. Okay, in a real account, which account is going to affect here? Cash account. Cash account we are going to pay it in a SBI bank. We are depositing amount in a SBI bank, so amount is going, cash is going out from our hand. So we will follow this table, real account. So what is going from out from our hand? Cash is going out from our hand. So this cash account will come under credit account. Okay, next one is personal account. Personal account, in a personal account, what account is affecting in this transaction? SBI bank. SBI bank is a personal account, we have already understood. Amount is going, who is the receiver here? SBI bank is a receiver. We are going to pay amount in a SBI bank, so SBI bank is a receiver here. So here is what? The personal account here. SBI bank is a receiver, so SBI bank will come under debit aspect. Okay, here is what, in this transaction, cash account is a credit, SBI bank is a debit. So next transaction we will see. Okay, here rupee 200 withdrawn from SBI bank. Now we are going to withdraw amount from 200 rupee amount from SBI bank. Here you can see SBI bank is a one account which this transaction is going to affect. And next one is, what we are going to withdraw from SBI bank? Cash we are going to withdraw. So here what will come? Cash account will come. Okay, SBI bank, bank names always should come under personal account. So SBI bank will come under personal account. Next one is cash account. Always cash account should come under real account. Okay, now we need to find out whether these accounts are on come under credit or debit aspects. So here what I will write? Personal account. Okay, here is what? Real account. Next one is SBI Bank. Personal account it is coming under. Who is receiving here? SBI Bank is a giver here because we are going to withdraw amount from SBI Bank. Means we are going to receive here. So SBI Bank is giver here. So SBI Bank will come under credit aspect. Okay, next account is what here? Cash account. Cash account will always should come, it should come under real account. So what comes into our hand? Cash is coming to our hand. So cash account should come under debit aspect. Okay. In this transaction, SBI Bank will come under credit aspect. Cash account will come under debit aspect. Now, next transaction is what? 1000 rupee transfer to Syndicate Bank from SBI Bank. We are transferring 1000 rupee amount from SBI Bank to Syndicate Bank. So two banks will come here. So cash is directly transferring from one bank to another bank. So cash account will not come here. So two banks will come, SBI Bank and Syndicate Bank. So both are bank names here. So both will come under personal account. This is also come under personal account. Okay. Next, after finding the accounts, what we need to follow? We need to follow golden rule here. Personal account, SBI Bank. SBI Bank is receiving or else transferring. We are transferring amount from SBI Bank to Syndicate Bank. Then SBI Bank is a giver here. So personal account, who is the giver here? SBI Bank is a giver here. So first we will write a transactions here. Sorry, first we will write accounts here. Both are personal account. Okay. Next I am following SBI Bank here. SBI Bank is a giver here. So SBI Bank will come under credit aspect. Next, this amount is received by Syndicate Bank. Then who is the receiver here? Syndicate Bank is a receiver. So this Syndicate Bank will come under debit aspect. Okay, next in this transaction, SBI Bank is a credit aspect, Syndicate Bank is debit aspect. I hope you all might have understood how to enter contra means bank related transactions in a journal. In a next video, I will show how to enter these transactions in a contra entry. Thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel.